Used a Pervy.
Alright. My first thing that I need to do is go to the river, do the shit there. Then I need to get bugs, and then warp around.
Warp around, maybe get down.
Actually, I might get bugs if I go to the grotto near the castle, so I guess I'll do that first, because I'm right here. This is really the most obscure... No, never mind. I was about to say this is the most obscure Skulltula. The one in Zora's Fountain is the most fucking obscure Skulltula. This one's a close second, though. Please climb the vine.
Never.
Good old blind guards. What would we do without you? There's one in Zora's Fountain where you have to come back with the iron gauntlets to lift a random boulder, and then it, like, gives you access to a hole that leads through a tunnel of invisible Skulltulas, and then it, like, dumps you out on top of a random ledge, and it's just up there. It is the weirdest thing.
Yeah, it's very strange.
Well, that's probably going to be, like, the second to last one that I get. The last one I'm going to get is by Ganon's Castle. But yeah, you just have to kind of know to do this.
Gotta sell those guidebooks.
Hopefully there's bugs in here. There's some bugs. I'm not gonna clone the token. Not cloning the damn token.
It's kind of hard to do anyway.
For anybody wondering about the clone and why people are talking about it, apparently, if you, like, grab the token and backflip into the teleporting light at the right time, you'll get the token, but it won't actually, like, get rid of it, so you can go back in and get another one. But yeah, I've never actually done it. Because I'm fine with using glitches to speed things up, but, that would not really count towards 100%, I think, because that just means I'm getting one of them multiple times and I'm not getting others. I will clone the bugs, because there's no reason not to. This run when money was an issue, and that immediately stopped being a problem as soon as I became an adult.
Essentially, yeah.
The hell was that? I still hate Zora's River. It is one of my least favorite areas to go through. You guys still remember what songs I played for you, right? Yep. And then again. Get one from this, and then do I get another one from playing with him again?
I'm not sure.
Because I thought there was two from this.
Thought there was only one.
It's not like I know which button is frickin' which. God, this is gonna be awful.
Well, it's laid out like in 64, right? Like the top four of the
Yeah, yeah, I kind of get it.
So it's, yeah.
I'll get it eventually. How was that not fast enough? Come on. Have to be super fast. Jesus Christ. Well, I'm not using the C-Stick, actually. Yeah, it's like you have to hit the button almost before you see which one it is. It's pretty bad. God damn it. Stop. Again. There we go. I like how the one on the top was never actually used.
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of glad, because that's the only one that isn't mapped to a button. So I should only be missing two, right? Yep, and I think both of those are through bean plants. At least I certainly hope so. On the GameCube controller, Z is down, Y is left, X is right, and there's nothing for up. So for up, you have to do up on the stick. Thank you. Did that clean up Death Mountain then? Yes. So what areas have I not cleaned out? Wasteland makes sense. That's good. Gerudo Valley, I'm apparently missing one. I'll have to check that out. That's done. That's done. That's Ganon's castle. That's done. That's done. That's done. 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 And I know of at least one there. Not sure which one I'm missing in Gerudo Valley. I'll check that out at some point.
Turns out Navi just leeches off of your life, and that's why she is uncomfortable when you are.
What do you mean?
Because the tunic thing.
Oh. Somewhere, just didn't know where. Apparently only missing 10. Now, let's go through 7 hours of Naburu dialogue.
Yeah, she does kind of...
Yeah, I don't know why they got rid of the dig TM. That was a little stupid. I picked the wrong option. Oh, now I think I'm okay. Talking on the beach, doot doot doot, talking on the beach, doot doot doot. Hey, Cubs. Yep, I'm still going at it. I'm gonna say there's somewhere between an hour and a half and 2 hours left. Hopefully not any more than that. Depends on how much time it takes me to do the frickin' big Poe hunt. Lose our wooden shield. Yeah, why did Vine Whip have such a low amount of PP in the early games? I always thought that was weird. Wait, we're in hour 11 now? Oh god.
Have you been playing non-stop?
Yeah.
Jesus.
It was originally stated that we would be switching off. That so did not happen.
You seem fine.
Yeah, I mean, I'm okay. I'm not, like, getting tired or anything.
Thank you.
Can I beat the game in an hour? No. If I was just playing it normally, still probably no. Since I have to do a bunch of extra shit, definitely no.
What were you saying no to?
Somebody said, can I beat this game in another hour?
Oh.
Can we not have to deal with this jackass, please? Leafage. I always forget that's a move. Does anything other than Rowlet learn it? Is this the longest stream ever? I don't know. We've done marathon ones before, but it very well could be. I don't usually marathon games like this. Fomantis learns it, okay. Oh hey, it's one of these weird ass enemies. These things are bizarre. I like how he actually started to pull up onto the ledge, and then I immediately ruined it. Oh, I didn't realize Tapu Bulu got leafage. Okay, then. I always forget that thing is a grass type.
Shit, I forgot too. Why is it a grass type? It's a pretty good starting question there.
It's the least fitting of the Tapus, I think.
Yeah, a little bit.
What
the fuck is this room?
Liz, I think they allegedly multiply if you hit them with bombs. I've never tried it. I guess I can check that out the next time I see some.
What is it?
The Anubis enemies.
Oh, yeah.
Grab that through the gate, why not? Oh, did I try it in Voyager? I don't even remember. I remember we made that like the enemy text because there was a guide that said that you could. Mean Look and Whirlwind at level 1. So it wants you to stay, and it wants you to fuck off at the same time. So you know what sucks about getting everything in the Spirit Temple, is if I miss something as a kid, I won't know until I'm done with the whole temple, because I don't have a way to check.
Yeah, that does kind of suck.
So I'm doing my best to be thorough here. What are you looking for?
I'm looking for my iPad pens. I thought I
ran. Oh, like the touch
pen
thing?
Yeah, I thought I ran the duck, but I don't see them.
I'm just thankful that there's no Skulltulas in the Gerudo Training Grounds. That would be kind of garbage if there were. I like how when I saw the types of the new Pokemon, like, I was looking at the UBs and I saw Nidalee was Rock Poison, and I thought that they gave it an intentionally unfitting type because it was, like, unworldly, and like, that's kind of cool. And then I kept looking at them, and then from that point on, they all more or less made sense, and I still don't really get why that thing is Rock Poison. Like, jellyfish are venomous, and it's made of glass or something, which could be considered rock, so I guess. But, like, I don't know, it's just weird.
What are you doing here?
For killing it. Oh boy, the big main room. My favorite room, because it's not impossible to get around in or anything. I kind of wish Zerkatree was electric grass. Nothing about it really screams grass, but it's a type combination that hasn't been done aside from Lawnmower Rotom, and it would be nice to have another.
Oh, Lawnmower!
A piece! Yeah, I think you can relate, like, maybe three or four of the UBs to the Deadly Sins, and the other ones just don't fit at all. Oh, we got a floating chest. First time I did that in the run. Anything else I can actually do in here as a kid? I don't think so. I swear there was an eye door, like an eye switch to open that door. Maybe that's in turn quest. The Young Link half of this dungeon's really short, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Oh wait, I still have that fucking garbage block pushing room. Oh god, I don't want to do this. This is the worst room ever. Which one are they saying Buzzswole is, Pride? Yeah, it's like I can see Gluttony and Lust. The other ones, I'd have to look at the list, but yeah, I doubt they really fit at all.
What?
For the Ultra Beasts being the seven deadly sins. I mean, I'm still not convinced that there's not a link between Nidalee and Lily. Like, it was probably the reverse of everybody initially thought, where it's like Lusamine was dressing her like that because she was insane, but I still don't get why Zerkatree has Guzma's hair, because I thought that one was also pretty similar. Cartana is Sloth, really? That doesn't even make sense. Isn't that thing fast?
That thing's fast as hell. How is it Sloth?
One of these days, I really should frickin' catch Celesteela and then the rest of them. I just keep getting distracted by shit. Thank God this isn't in turn quest, because I remember that being a lot more annoying in that game. Because I think, like, every one of these blocks had a sun symbol and they all unlocked stuff. I also really hope there's no sculptures in here. I'm not seeing any. Yeah, I knew you were there. You're a fuckface, aren't you? Thankfully, I remembered that. How many post-game things have I caught? Well, I caught all four of the Tapus and Beast Balls. I reset for a good-natured... Oh, what the shit? I need another key? Where? Yeah, I got a good-natured type null. Lunala, obviously, I caught because you have to. I got that in the Moon Ball. Nihiligo, I got in the Lure Ball. Pheromosa, I got one in a Love Ball and the other three in Premieres. Zerkatree, I got one in a Fastball and the other in a Premiere. I still have to get one of the Celesteelas in a Friend Ball, plus the other one in the Premiere. Guzzlord in a Heavy Ball, and then Necrozma in another Beast Ball. Plus, I have to pick up Magearna and Cosmog. Okay, so where in the hail did I miss a key? Yeah, UBs can be caught in anything. If you use a non-beast ball on them, they have a times 0.6 catch rate, but it is possible. And so, getting them in the Apricorn Balls is pretty much the most annoying thing you could ever do, because you only have one chance and then you have to reset, but, I've been working on it. Got three of them at least.
Hold the majority at least.
Yeah, I don't know where the hell to go. Anybody know where to go? Because I don't.
Go the right way.
Really?
Yeah. That's all I got.
It's stupid, because I'm pretty sure I've been thorough.
I never really did well in the Spirit Temple.
Like, what could I have possibly missed? Yeah, I've seen that thing about the sounds that all the UBs make. The two box legends and, wait, there were torches in the room before the key door. Oh. I think I know what you mean. Okay. But yeah, I was starting to say, the UBs... And the two box legends in Necrozma all have the same sound play in their cry. These are totally lit. Is this the room you meant? It's not in the main room, is it? I actually didn't explore the main room very well. Maybe I should. Oh, the room with the blocks? Okay. Yeah, they also have prime numbers for stats, which is kind of weird. I think the in-game explanation is that the three main ones have, like, been in the regular world so long that they no longer have, like, the Ultra Beast aura on them or something. But they originated from the other dimension, though. Isn't type null with Eviolite, like, not that good? Because I don't think it can really do a whole lot. I don't know, I haven't looked at its moveset. Like, even Silvally's not that great, but I think it's cool. I like being able to switch its type. It is the first legendary I have used in a long time. Theory about Necrozma being the origin of the Z crystals. I have not read that. I'm kind of curious what that theory is. Like, where they're getting that from. Best nature for Silvally? I mean, I went for Jolly because multi-attack is physical and it is just a good nature for that. I don't know. I think one of the main, good things about it is that, one of the best things that Silvally can do is, Z Parting Shot, which is it's basically an automatic switch-out move that lowers the opponent's stats and also heals whatever Pokemon you're sending in back to full health. So it's a fairly good utility move. But if you do that, then it has to be holding a Z-Crystal, so it has to be Normal-type, which is a bit of a shame. Where the hell are all the torches in here? Okay, hold on. There's one. I can't fucking tell. Let me just blow up these guys. Parting Shot by itself is basically a switch out in order to lower stats move, but with the Dark Z Crystal, it does the Healing Wish thing, yeah. May I have another? Light the fucking torch, Link. Come on. There we go.
I like the sounds of, 50 simultaneous
blades. Yeah. Chang, chang!
What is this, Tomb Raider?
Sure is still alive. There we go. Yeah, the fact that there's only one event Pokemon does kind of hint that it's going to be shorter than usual, but it depends on if they're going to be wasting a lot of the time with releasing the, hat Pikachus and the unreleased Mega Stones and shit. By the way, for anybody who doesn't follow, Pokemon news super closely, the Mawile and Beedrill stones are being given out if you enter the next tournament thing, the online competitions. And I don't ever do those, and I really don't want to do this one. It annoys me to not get the stones, though, so I haven't really decided what I'm going to do yet. Alright, I think we are about to say goodbye to Young Link for good now. Kia, what is this, an octopus? Okay, bye.
It's been fun.
Yep, there's a heartbeat there. Good. Okay. Time to warp. Yeah, the Pikachu with a hat prediction from the dream was pretty good. I don't remember saying there were portals to another world in that, but I don't doubt it. So, yep, we're doing Poe hunting. It's, the most tedious thing I have left to do, so I might as well get it out of the way now. I don't know where they all are, which really spells good things for the future. So I gotta do Poe hunting, I have to get the last few Skulltulas laying around, I have to briefly warp to Death Mountain Crater to get a heart piece, I have to do the training grounds, and then I have to finish the temple. I got the one that was right here at the crossroads. Yeah, is the one by this tree? There is not one by the tree. There is one by this tree, though. Oh my god. Yeah, I remember this one sucking. This is, like, the worst one. It immediately goes into a wall. Oh, this sucks. For anybody who doesn't know, these only show up when you're on Epona, so I am having to do it like this. Come on. Fuck.
you're shooting a Pona.
Yeah. Yeah, just a little bit. God, this thing sucks. How? Don't think there's a better way to do this either. Please.
Get a longer head start on that, maybe.
I think I want to be as slow as possible, really. Oh, yeah. I can't target this thing.
Can't you go down there and activate it?
I don't think so. I can't even fucking hit it. Like, I've gotten it a couple times, but I have to hit it twice in one go.
Yeah. Try activating it down there, though.
I'm pretty sure if you do, it just goes straight into a wall. Can I use fire arrows? I'm not sure. Well, I've got 11 arrows left. I'll keep trying.
You can run over grass.
I know. Oh my god. God, finally. Clamiao's ears are different in Gen 7. Okay, then. Alright, so that's three down. I certainly do not know where any others are, so I'm just gonna kind of wander. I like how I just ran it over. Maybe get a few more arrows from that. Oh, wait, I hear one. No? Okay, maybe not. No, the one that I just ran over wasn't a big Poe. That was a regular one. Well, okay, I didn't get any more arrows. I'd still say Twilight Princess's Poes are worse than this. These suck, but at least there's only 10 of them and not 60. Alright, let me go turn these in. I don't really have a opinion as far as 3D models versus sprites for Pokemon. I think the models are actually really good on almost all of them. There were some animations I wish were different, like the random hovering ones, but the models themselves are fine. Yeah, and I like the Gen 5 animations. A lot of people complain about them being kind of janky and pixelized, and they're not wrong, but I still appreciate the attempt, and I don't think that it is bad enough to make them, like, to make that, like, a big problem. Yeah, the Hitmontop sprite actually was pretty bad, though. It was just kind of, like, waving back and forth on its head instead of spinning. That was really stupid. Alright, I need to either run over a grass patch and get a bunch of arrows, or I need to go buy some. I would prefer to not go buy them. Not because of money, but just because it's out of the way and annoying. Okay, I think there's one that appears near this river. That's half of them. I, once again, desperately need to find a grass patch. Did I get the one by this tree? Apparently not. And I can't get it now. Alright, so I'll remember that there's one by the tree. Is there one by this boulder? They're usually by landmarks. If there was one by the boulder, it didn't spawn. Come on, arrows are usually super common. What is this? I guess we're going to buy arrows. Fun. Let's go to frickin' Kokiri Forest. Actually, I don't know if they sell arrows. If that one didn't take fucking 40 to kill, then we wouldn't be having this problem. Well, isn't Dunsparce 5 feet long? And not 5 feet tall. Like, that would make more sense. Where even is the store here? I think it's up here. Yeah, it's like my first time actually spending money on something. At a store, at least. Yo, give me all your arrows. the quest continues. Excuse me. Want to try that again? Okay. Now, I'm already forgetting what I've done, so I'm still pretty convinced that there's one near this river, unless I already got it, because I already freaking forgot. So, let's find out. Could have sworn there was one here that you had to get to spawn and then, like, shoot it while it was going across the river or something. Is that not a thing? Well, I don't know. Because, yeah, I think I've got 6 so far, and I don't even remember what half of those were, so we continue to wander. I think there's one by this tree, if I remember right. Yep. I think that's one of the harder ones to get. Alright. And time to turn him in again. Yeah, Eternal Flow Out's still in the codon. Like, it actually has, like, programmed Pokedex data, I think, and a full model and stuff, whereas the, cosplay Pikachus and the spiky-eared Pichu don't. They have box sprites for some unknown reason. Turns out they're still planning to release Floette as a Gen 6 event. They're just gonna wait, like, until Gen 9 is out, and then they'll do it, and then you have to transfer it all the way up. Alright, we've got 3 left to find. I'm positive that one of them is in, like, a wooded area in the bottom right, and I don't know where the others are. Somebody said there was one near Gerudo Valley, unless that was the one I just got. two in the wooded area. Okay, so it doesn't look like there's any over here. Oh, wait. Do you get one to spawn at this rock? No. Okay. Well, there goes one idea. Yeah, the Pokewalker wasn't useless. It was just obnoxious. Is there one by this section? I think eventually somebody's gonna have to look up a guide where all these are, because I'm gonna run out of ideas pretty soon. One by this rock. So how about those two that are supposed to be in this tree area? Oh, there was one. Is it already gone? Yep, okay. Let's try that again. I can't click links, though. So, like, I'm kind of hoping that somebody's been paying semi-attention to which ones I've gotten, and then they can tell me where the others are.
I mean, if we switch channels, we can look at it.
Oh, God, yeah, there's a whole ton of them being posted at once. I can't read all that.
You can scroll off.
Yeah, hold on. Okay. Sign indicating the direction towards Lon Lon Ranch. I'll just... I'm going to be looking through these, so anybody saying stuff in the chat currently, I'm not going to be able to see it because I have it frozen on this. Let me go back into the woods and make sure there aren't any in here. The woods, I call them, and it's just kind of a few. Oh, there is one. Okay. Only one left. Okay. So let me just visit these in order. The sign indicating the direction towards Lon Lon Ranch just ahead of the market's entrance. I am almost positive I got that one, but I'm gonna double check. Located next to the entrance to Lon Lon Ranch. I did that one. Again, just checking to be sure. What about this sign? No, okay. Yeah, I did the tree. In one of the bushes next to the river in the open area. That one I'm thinking I got. I'm just gonna be super careful with these. I don't want to assume anything. Division leading to Gerudo Valley, southwest of Lon Lon Ranch. That one was right here, right? Yeah, I did that one. the lone tree west of Lon Lon Ranch, close to the entrance of Gerudo Valley. Is that this? Oh, wait. Okay, that's the one I was thinking of. So what's the roads division? Is that up here? I don't think I've looked up here, actually. There might be one. The roads division southwest of Lon Lon Ranch. I don't know what that means. I'm looking at the map and I see places where the road kind of breaks apart a bit, but I don't know if that's what it's talking about. Oh, wait, it's right here, isn't it? Oh, okay, that's it. Alright, now that I know where it is, let me catch up. Alright, so I'm looking at the chat again for anybody who cares. I just gotta shoot this one. Cool fucking Poe. No? No, we are not going to spawn from that direction? Okay. Please hit it. Please! Of course, the last one's got to be a pain in the ass. You know, we need that fourth bottle. It's important. Wait, how is being the one playing it, like, worse than being the one watching it? In terms of, like, need to get a life or whatever. Yep, all this was for a bottle. They are useful, but, like, this was a lot of work for one, and I'm fine with the three. What was the fifth bottle in Link Between Worlds? I don't remember. Because I 100%ed that, I just don't remember the specifics of it. From giving a shit ton of rupees to the fairy, yeah, I remember that one. I don't remember it being a bottle, I just remember giving a shit ton of rupees to the fairy. Yay! Nope, we don't have all the sculptures yet. We are missing probably like five. Seven. I'm about to go get one of them right now. One of the stupidest ones. I think there's only, like, maybe one Skulltula that I don't know the location of. And it's somewhere in Gerudo Valley. I'll have a look around in the place in a little while. But yeah, first I've got to get the one that is 9 hours out of the way. And then we get to warp to Death Mountain Crater and get a heart piece there. I still haven't raced for the frickin' cow. I should do that. Training grounds, which I can probably skip most of if I know what I'm doing. Problem is, I don't. I like my current list of items, the 3 bottles, it's pretty good. I forgot I could have taken the Kokiri Forest Warp here. Actually, I don't know if that would have been any faster, though. No, I got all the ones from putting bugs and stuff. That's a bonus song. I got that one. I got the one that's, like, at the beginning by the wooden bridge. And I think I got one behind, like, a pillar. I don't know what other ones there would be. I'll have a look around. It's probably... like, the area isn't that big. At night behind the tent. Okay, that would be it. This is one of the stupidest things in the entire game. You throw this big rock. Like, you have to come all the way back here after the Spirit Temple. Who's gonna think to do that? Drop in the hole, and it looks like it's just a tunnel, but nope, invisible enemies. Which I'm just gonna ignore, because I don't need to fight them. Go up a big ladder, and then it's just kind of up here. Like, this should have been a heart piece. And even then, it would have been one of the most obscure heart pieces in the game. Alright, is that it for Zora's River? Yes, it is. Okay. Done, done, done. Done, done, done. Need the one by Ganon's castle. Done, done. Get the one by the tent. Done. I think there's one on, like, a mound. And there's still a few in the Spirit Temple. I'm gonna actually hold off on the training ground until I'm done with Spirit Temple at this point. Oh, oh! Alright. Got it. Actually, no, I'm putting that off. Let me do. and do the other crap first. Because if I warp here later, it's going to trigger the whole Zelda cutscene, so I don't want to do that yet. Well, that sentence didn't make any sense, but whatever. Just ignore the brown shriekers here. Good thing Epona can teleport, because otherwise, who knows how long it would take for her to show up. And I'm assuming it has to be daytime for Malin to be here, so we get to immediately play another song. This isn't difficult. I don't really remember much of it. Nice person. I don't know why she didn't jump. I wasn't going at a weird angle or anything.
Yeah, don't use carrots on the low ones, obviously.
Right.
Should count.
It doesn't. I'm only doing it because you actually do get something for doing it. It's not like the running man race.
You should use a carrot at the beginning.
Why not?
Because that's a low fence. Like these little bitty fences, they don't need carrots at all.
I know, but I'm just. It's just for the sake of going fast, though. It was a waste of 5 minutes, but it could have been worse. Wait, was that not fast enough? Do I have to beat 50 seconds?
We go down to 49, I think.
Ugh.
Yeah, that's
Okay. I'll get right on that, Chase. Fuck off. I wish I could just quit the race.
You can jump over a fence and it'll quit for you.
Oh. Okay. At least I don't have to spend money on this. Once again, not that I'm low on money, but because I might eventually run out. Okay. I took the bow out. Good job. Yeah, I think I'm gonna give this a few more attempts, and if I'm not getting it, then I don't know if I care enough. Like, I've done it before, it's just stupid. It's giving me trouble because I'm not that good with Epona. Track for beating 50 seconds. Come on. Oh. Got it.
Yeah.
Stupidest thing in the game. Well, it's not the stupidest thing in the game at all, but it's stupid because it's not needed for 100% and I did it anyway. Alright.
Delivered to your house?
No, I don't want to do the race again.
Just jump over the fence.
I'm just gonna leave.
Bye.
No, no, we're not gonna leave. We can't jump that fence.
Line up
okay, I just wanna get on my damn horse and leave. Thank you.
Let's leave!
Yeah, you just get a cow delivered to your treehouse. That's literally the reward.
Sounds good.
So yeah, as far as like random minigames that have a definable like score in them, other than like the shooting games, well there's the Gerudo Archery, which is a shooting game, but it has a actual, like, high score that you can get, because you can get 2,000. You don't get anything for doing it, so I'm not going to bother. There's the Running Man race, which is unwinnable, and it's only to see how fast you can do it, and you don't get anything, so I'm not doing it. And then there was that, which had a stupid reward, but it was a reward nonetheless, so I did it. Epona, I don't know what your current deal is, but I'm done with you. Also, that was pretty good right there.
Well, this game does have an achievement box that you can look at.
makes us the last one for this area. Yes, it is. Okay. Off to the Haunted Wasteland. Except, yet again, here I am playing the song and realizing I shouldn't do it, because I'm frickin' right here and I should just do the training ground while I'm in the area. So, that's just gonna be the second...
The gauntlet?
Hmm?
The gauntlet?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
What all is left? I have to do the training ground to get the ice arrows. I have to get, like, 6 Skulltulas, I think. Is it 6? Let me look. It's 5, okay. Done, 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 missing one, done, 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 missing one. So, hopefully there's 3 in the Spirit Temple still. If there's not, then I'm kind of boned because I have to check every temple again. This level does not have a map or a compass in it, so I actually won't know if I have all the keys. As long as I get enough to get the ice arrows, I am fine with missing the rest. Yeah, I went back to all 3 of the child dungeons. I should have the Skulltulas from every dungeon, except for Spirit Temple. Because I'm fairly sure I checked all of them before I finished. I'm sure good at this. Okay, where the fuck are the last ones? Oh. They're just kind of right here. Alright. Eh. To drop off the cliff, or is that... No, that's only Master Quest. Oh, alright. Oh, this room sucks. Okay. Wait, I didn't have to bring blue fire into here, did I? Isn't there a place where you get it?
Yeah, there's a place.
Okay. I think some of the silver rupees have really bad hitboxes. And it's easy to not notice that, like, it's easy to kind of like get close and not touch them, but I don't think there's a glitch that prevents them from being picked up. Likes. Oh, come on. Why did they randomly become unhittable? I don't get that. What is this? There's a chest in one of these holes. Oh, that's because it appears. Okay. Yeah, huge rupee. Yeah, the silver gauntlets don't make any damn sense. At least they're not as overblown as the golden ones, though. The golden ones are hilarious. Okay, now that key there was just mean. That is so easily missable. Oh, cool. Ice trap. I forgot these existed. Look how I just randomly guessed that. I don't need to be up here necessarily. Thing. Okay. Thank you.
Really?
Shooting the eyes of a statue in a Zelda game, I would have never guessed. If it was Ultimate 8, every chest would explode. Yeah. That's true. Every single chest. All right, fine, I'll bite. Navi, do the thing again. Know where to stand. No, no, that's not good enough for you. Piece of shit, come on. Whatever, I'll just go back. Oh, okay, I guess I'm not going back yet. Find a secret passage.
Remind me to check.
Still shut, really. About to say I'll come back into this one once I backtrack, but no.
You'll come back.
Does the chest in that room give you a single arrow? I don't know. Okay, well, there's the backtracking door. Still need to know how to get rid of the flame. Guess like that. Is there anything else in here? Nope. Turns out this is an ice trap. At least this isn't a long dungeon. I think it's fairly simple to get through if you know all the tricks. Is there not more than one door in here? I don't know what to do. I have to go around. Oh, the chest is on the platform with the statues? Oh, so it is. Okay. I didn't know that was a void. Alright. Well, going back. There's, I think, still a door that I haven't explored. And that upper ledge, I think, had another door. I don't freaking know. That was pretty good right there. No? No? Okay. You know, it's kind of a shame, actually. I think this is one of the best dungeons in the game. It's weird that it's completely optional. There's one just sitting around, alright. Yeah, this is still training grounds. What did that do? Did that do anything at all? Oh, that's what it did. Okay. Yeah, I probably have enough keys now, but I'm just gonna keep going. I don't give a shit. Cool! I don't have to re-get those, do I? Okay, good. I think in an interview they said that Link does get a green tunic in that game, but I don't really think it's a big deal even if he doesn't. Oh, actually, here's the key room. Let's see. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for it. Let me see if I remember how to get through this place. Or is this like a single rupee? I remember there's a part where you have to go through the ceiling. I just don't know where that is. Can't get the ice arrows from here. Oh, do I not have enough keys? Continues to use keys. Yeah, I think I'm gonna run out, but I'll just head back when I do. I think I'm like one short. Maybe two short? I couldn't tell. Either way, we're going back. Stuff in here, apparently. Is that a key, or is that just gonna be arrows or some shit? Yeah, favorite base, cool. Favorite. There's stuff on the pillars. Thank you for reminding me that that fire was there, game. That was very kind of you. Okay, so what the hell does this lower door do? Wait, is this a fake door? It is. That's annoying. This whole time I was wanting to backtrack here because I thought that was a real door that I missed. Don't make me get out the lens. Thank you. And yeah, there is a door up here. What does this go to? My real fake doors joke earlier on. Oh yeah, this stupid room. I forgot about this one. I don't remember a Gerudo ever using a bow and arrow. I saw your post about that, I just didn't comment on it. Yeah, Grab by the Ghoulies was kind of fun from what I played of it. Not fun enough for me to finish it, but it was okay. Really? That didn't count? I'm very thankful that this room doesn't have a timer, because I thought it did. It is weird that it requires the song a time. I never thought about that. I mean, it makes about as much logic as a lot of other stupid video game shit, but still, it's a good observation. Spike. Close enough. Hit by it a few more times. Yeah, this is basically just the toilet. That's why they have all the water here that could be using for other resources.
Waste doing this.
Like I said, it's the toilet. They've got the river. Just get a bucket pulley system and it'll be fine. Hey, look, it's a Dinolfo. You don't see these very often. And the entire freaking border of the room is flame walls. Good. Okay, that was a good room. Glad I did it. Do we have enough keys now? I feel like this should be enough. Yep, we've looped back around. Okay. That has got to be enough. Where did you come from? I don't remember this chest being here. April Fool's hack with all the fire. Yeah, I forgot about that. That thing was pretty good. Was that like Hell's Nightmare? Wow, there's just barely enough keys. Okay. I thought that there were extras. Maybe I just didn't open them in a good order. Gotta go through 97 more doors to get out, and we'll be good. I would save warp, but honestly, the amount of time it takes to load the game back up, because it's the GameCube version, probably outweighs the benefit, so I'm just gonna go back. Oh, actually, does this work? I thought you couldn't use them inside. Okay, so this should be the final heart piece, and I think basically the final Skulltula that isn't either in the dungeon or outside Ganon's castle. There's one over here, right? Maybe not on this. Yeah, that was a mistake. Okay, let's try that again. I don't know if I mean, we explained it earlier, but I guess I can explain it again. We don't remember the name of the hack, but there was this really shitty hack that was posted on a fan website, where Link was basically a transvestite. Like, I know that that's considered an offensive term now, but that's what he was. There was cleavage, and he had, like, bedroom eyes, and it was really stupid looking. And the Door of Time had, like, these burning faces on them that were extremely stupid looking. And, there's this great fairy picture that I post every once in a while, and it's from that hack. It just has, like, this really terrible face. But, possibly the best part of it is the fact that, of the kid dungeons, they were all being reworked into, like, different types of locations, and, Jabu Jabu's belly was changed into inside Rudo's womb. And, the original thread going over this, and there's still another one here? Alright, I'll bite. Where the hell is the last one? But yeah, it was just, like, the original thread was full of people making fun of it, and it was pretty great. Levers could frickin' lever me alone for 2 seconds, that would be beautiful. Okay, so that leaves two in the Spirit Temple. One of them I definitely know the location of, the other one I assume I'll be bumping into, and the one outside Ganon's castle. We are definitely in the final stretch. I do not have any fairies. I really should have grabbed one, but whatever. Be fine. Once again, remembering intern quest. Trying to remember how you get around in this place, because I thought there was, like, a bunch of switches and shit in here, but no. No, you just push the big block, and that's about it. C-stick.
C-stick.
That looks like a compass if ever I saw one. Yeah, it's like... I know that nobody's, like, upset about it in the chat, so... I'm glad that people are being, like, good, but, to me, like, I understand why it happens, and... Not to get overly, like, preachy or whatever, I am not in any, like, minority groups where there are really bad words for me, but I do feel like just randomly deciding that a word is now offensive is just really stupid. Like, how it used to be fine to say midget and now you can't. Like, it's not like to me, saying midget... It's just what they're called. But apparently now they're called something else, and so if you say that, it's bad.
It's more about, like, the history of the word being used rather than the word itself. Like,
yeah.
Like the term faggot or, you know, tranny or something
like that. I understand that.
Like, it's
but it's like, but those, but like with those, like, faggot was intentionally meant to be insulting. Like, it was used specifically to hurt people.
Right.
Other stuff, I don't know if it has been.
I don't know about the history, like, of the word midgets.
So, like, that was just an example. The word transvestite, I'm not sure, because I thought that was just what they were called before it became more, like, common.
Some people still call
themselves
that. I think it's accepted to not use that term, depending on if, you know... Because it depends on if they care or not.
Oh, here's the other one.
Well, the N-word's being reappropriated by its, like, by black people, but only by black people, so white people still can't use it.
Anyway, while I was talking about that, I must point out that first silver rupee there, I swear it is possible to get without the hover boots, but it's really annoying. And that was always, like, my number one reason for why you're supposed to do Shadow before Spirit, but this is an optional section.
That's true. They did change the spelling of it, but I suppose the meaning is still there.
Where the hell did you come from? I really hate lifelinks.
I mean, I'm certainly not going to use it either way.
Yeah, it's like, I mean, that one... There's enough bad history behind the whole thing.
I don't really
that
see
it's just,
why...
It's kind of one of those things like, okay, let's all agree to not say it.
I don't know. I mean, if they want to reappropriate it, that's fine. It's just...
Every fucking time.
You can just stun it with the long shot. You know that you can do that. Or with the arrows.
I thought you could only stun it with the boomerang.
Swing sideways. Not up and down.
Well, this isn't.
Because it's the middle that's the soft bit. Mm. It's the tips that's the hard. Yee-yee-ass haircut.
I like the yee-yee-ass haircut.
I wouldn't say faggot. I don't know. It seems harsh. It's like a harsh word. Yeah, I don't like it either.
Hitting.
Yeah, the cigarette thing is kind of strange to
ice trap.
Run into.
Ice trap. Nope. I think the next one's an ice trap. Gotta find out. Yep.
Hello, Jack Forever.
And I assume the last one does nothing. But I gotta check.
Don't do it. Creepy that sun looks.
Yeah, it's got a bit of a face on it.
I think it also means a bundle of sticks. It can be cigarette or a bundle of sticks. That was close. Yeah, I wouldn't use it for negative connotations.
How do I get up there?
I don't know, words are weird.
Really? Oh, wait. Yeah, I don't know, that might just have to hover boot over there or something. Let's see. Gotta do this at least once. The stupidest thing. It's just a programmer having a jape.
What?
Hmm?
What?
Where you can hookshot the nipple.
Oh, yeah. Which shooting gallery? There's a couple of them.
I think they're pretty much identical, though. I never really had too much of a problem with them. Like, every once in a while.
They're both rupees, right?
What?
The shooting gallery.
The ones where you shoot the rupees, yeah.
Ooh. Yeah, I mean, a rose by any other name.
Yeah, latching onto the nipple is just a random Easter egg. Like I said, it was a programmer having a jape. Oh, when was there a chest over there?
Night Shyamalama Ding Dong. Benny Cabbage Patch. Bender usually means, like, drunk or alcoholic.
Yeah, I thought that going on a bender meant, like, getting wasted.
I'm sorry, Subutonic. People are kind of terrible.
I don't even know if I have to do this.
I think it's shortcut or something.
I wasn't sure if there was anything important in here. Looks like probably not. Oh well, did it anyway.
Yeah, I can understand that, Subatomic.
To be very upset if it turns out I need another key somewhere after this room. Because I have every,
That's why Cheese has to get it out of his system when he's online.
I have every Skulltula now. So I just need to finish the dungeon. With these things, because they're weird. I could just use dense fire, but that's not nearly as fun. Okay, like I'm just using dense fire.
Screw it. Hit them with the sword.
These things are cool.
They are funky.
They're very out of place.
I don't think so.
They're just not used as an
I mean, they fit with the temple. It's just they're really weird for Zelda enemies. They're very forgettable.
Most Zelda games have something like it. I mean, I don't know about the 3D ones, but I can think of enemies like them in the 2D ones.
Yeah, in person, it's like most people don't go up and introduce themselves and just kind of let people know. So, yeah.
Quickly now. Is that how you're supposed to do that?
Well, we live in towards the like Dallas area, so it's not as bad as it could be in rural areas. Like, we have fairly good judges here and stuff.
Well, wasn't that an exciting battle?
This is a good battle.
I love how it just plops down. Why did they do that? So you don't long shot up to it?
I mean, I did have the asshole manager the other night, but other than that, like, I've not run across any issues.
You probably won't in the city. Dallas is just as much Texan as New York City is.
We attract a very large LGBT community. We're not sure why either.
Yeah, it just kind of happened.
It just happened.
Thank you.
Yeah, Dallas seems okay.
Dallas, so that.
Somebody just said that. What is that from?
That's from a YouTube poop.
What's Dallas? Dallas Jelly.
Dallas Jelly.
What the hell is Dallas Jelly?
Dallas Jelly is,
He got super upset over that.
In Spoonie's review of the Ring, not the movie, but the video game, based...
Well, are you telling us or the chat? Because
I think chat. Both.
Okay.
Yeah, I think Texas wanted to secede and wasn't its own thing.
I don't think it ever was.
I don't know. It wants to be its own thing. I mean, I wouldn't care if it was its own thing.
I don't know what that would affect. Probably
like the random water temple platform right there.
You mean as far as us not being part of the United States?
Yeah.
That would be a really bad idea. Texas would basically immediately liquidate.
Wouldn't that be like Brexit?
I know a lot of... Yeah. I know Texas like wanted to succeed for a while. Yeah, it was a republic for 9 years because it couldn't get into the U.S.
Hmm. Well, that was when it was like first made though, right? I think that was the case.
I don't know much about the history of Texas.
From what I remember, when Texas as a landmass was secured from Mexico, there was a lot of politics behind it admitting it to the U.S.
Yeah.
And not really because of anything specific to Texas, but because of other things going on in the country at the time. So, in Spoonie's review of the Ring Terror's realm, you can go down to the cafeteria in the main, like, hub area, and there's, like, a buffet bar, and it has, you know, all the different sections labeled, and it'll say, like, chicken, salad, and then there's one that just says Dalid Jelly, or at least that's what it appears to say. It's, like, the textures are so low quality, it's really hard to make out what it says, but he sees this, and he just goes completely ballistic, not able to understand what this thing is.
I enjoy the Dalid Jelly. Yeah, the lawyer I spoke to said that I got lucky in terms of being in Dallas, because the judges should be fairly good. So I'm kind of hoping for the name change that I get a good judge.
Okay.
Lizard. It's the
dinosaur. No, it's a lizard. I don't know why they're still using these enemies.
Cause.
Hey, you. Get out of here. What do you think you're doing?
No, you have to go in front of a judge for your name change. I already had to send in fingerprints and they had to do a background check to make sure you aren't a criminal. Fun going in front of judges. Well, there's this temple and then Ganon Trials left, right?
Yep, and then we'll finally be done.
I know we hit 12 hours. I don't know about 13 yet.
Okay, why?
Oh. In my heart, we're 34.
Whatever, it's just fucking arrows.
Yeah.
Wait, is it? I don't know if I need a key. I hope I don't need a key.
You shouldn't need a key after this, because this just lowers.
I like this mechanic that gets used just here and then never again.
Yeah, it's kind of... It's really cool, the whole crumbling face. I don't really get why it does it, but it's cool.
Missed.
Funky mechanic.
You always, always hated getting to the boss and then realizing I didn't get, like, a boss key.
Yeah.
Always sucked. I don't like any of the smashes. I'm equally hatred of all of them.
Aww. Aww, I thought you liked Melee, though.
Melee was like, I liked Soul Calibur better, to be honest. Because me and Dad played Smash Bros. Like on the N64 a lot, but we played a heck of a lot of Soul Calibur.
Weird little cutscene.
I wonder if you could actually snap your fingers in armor. I don't think you could.
Depends on what kind of armor it is. If it's like a full gauntlet, like metal gauntlet, probably not. But if it's just like covered with metal with leather gloves, I don't know. It wouldn't snap properly. Because I don't think you can snap in leather gloves.
I like how that took about 2 seconds.
Yeah.
I don't like the melee crowd. They're a bit...
They do seem to be pretty elitist.
They're kind of elitist, yeah.
Like, I still think that every Smash game got better than the previous. Brawl did take a couple steps back in terms of mechanics, but not to such a degree that
I kind of enjoyed some of the characters before. But I don't play it that often to really care about the minute details of Smash. That mean elitist?
Think basically,
they're better than everybody else.
It's basically the people who are like super hardcore competitive players and look down on anybody who plays the other games or even like enjoys any aspect of
like
them.
You're not supposed to enjoy Brawl or enjoy Forge.
It's like
you're
I think it like at Evo where they have the fighting game tournaments. Like, there's people who get pissed off that Smash 4 is even allowed there.
Yeah, they're like want to boycott it and shit. Like, it's stupid.
Like, not every Melee fan is an elitist, but right. A lot of them are, yeah. So.
I guess it's kind of one of those things where the fandom ruins the product, kind of like some people think with Undertale.
Yeah.
Or, like, bronies or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the product itself is fine, it's just the fandom that kind of overrides it a little bit.
Yeah, that worked out well. How did that not even reflect? Like, what the hell was that? Also, I should save.
I mean, if you like the game, yeah, that's fine. Oh yeah, you haven't saved in a while. Like, we're not saying the game is bad. Oh, that's interesting. I don't think I've ever seen a mid-freeze roll like that.
Yeah, that was a bit weird. I'm gonna die to this boss.
She is kind of rough. If the RNG is bad. And it looks like the RNG is gonna be bad for you for a little bit. Oh, come on, you can get that. Oh.
That really should have counted.
That would have been really good. The hitboxes are weird on them. Best thing is to just continually.
Nice. Dumbass.
Good job.
Let's just be inside each other here for a minute.
Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever works.
I haven't seen much of Steven Universe.
I haven't seen anything of it.
Fandom, so I don't know what the fandom's like. The heck is Johnny Galaxy? I like it when they do this. They, like, get real near each other. Works out really well.
Yeah, this one's not worth it.
I mean, I would still reflect it just in case they do come over.
Okay, are we done with this phase yet?
Give it a minute. Let's get serious now.
And N64 jiggle physics.
Good camera.
This is a really cool boss.
I do like
it. I hate the first phase of it.
The first phase does suck a lot, but... I do like the concept behind it. It's very nice. Cool. Nice.
I was hoping I could get that.
That was cool. Golf clap. That's all I can muster.
And best argument. And best noise.
Single cycle hype. The best noise. I want that on a 10-hour loop on YouTube in at least 5 minutes.
God.
Dragon from Fire Temple takes off a lot of health, so it can be hard. Are they related to Grunty?
Oh.
Oh!
Not sure what that was all about.
Well,
okay.
Link's a little fresher than we thought. Should have just left it. Not collected it.
Okay, so we get this cutscene, followed by Zelda Light Arrows cutscene. Then we get to go to the Ganon's Tower, do the fucking trials, leave halfway through them. What?
Made our gate crawler happy.
Leave halfway through it to get the heart upgrade, and then we'll be done pretty soon. Pretty soon, I say, as if it won't be at least an hour.
Mustard is always here.
Okay, so... I'm going to be reading the troll answers, but I'm going to be ignoring them. But outside of catching the loach, doing the running man race... and any other kind of, like, thing with a high score that I didn't get the highest possible score, is there anything that I have missed in this run? I'd like to know.
You didn't get the Triforce. You have to blow up all the gossip stones, and then you have to go and talk to Zelda, and then Sheik will show up and teach you the Song of the Sages. And then there's a step that was never given.
Okay.
But then you'll find the Temple of Light, and then you'll do that.
So nobody seems to have any serious answers yet.
You didn't find Dempe's pet pig.
I've never actually done a YouTube stream. I'm not sure how it works, really.
I stream more on my channel. He streams... not as often on this one. I've been going through GTA.
Yeah, I did Mask Side Quest. I got every item upgrade. All that stuff.
We're not as peppy right now. Because we're on hour 13.
Mm-hmm. I'm still not really regretting doing this, though. Like, it has been bad at a couple parts, but it could have been worse.
Plonk.
So, is this the 7-minute cutscene?
I think the 7-minute cutscene's when Zelda talks about the, what's the scene with the goddess things?
With, like, in the castle? I thought this was the longest cutscene.
I don't remember if this is the longest cutscene or if...
Well, it's already...
How many times do we have to see this scene?
This is the third...
Well, it's already past midnight, so I can't get another Thursday Island scan Pokemon. Oh, well.
Yeah, this is the third cutscene with this year.
How the fuck do you do this in 4 hours? Like, I mean, I know there's a ton of speed tricks,
you get proficient.
But still.
I mean, you had no route, so, yeah.
Right, I mean, I'm not saying that my run was going to be good, but I don't know how you get it down that low, though. It just doesn't seem like enough time to do
you
everything.
Do skips. You
do a lot of warping around and, like, a lot of getting places really fucking fast,
like,
with
you do,
tech.
You do skips, you don't get everything and all that.
What do you mean you don't get everything? It's 100%.
Well, yeah, but, I mean, you don't get, like, the map or the compass or whatever, I think. I don't think those are counted. Unless I've missed that and it isn't counted now. You've also gone fishing and, things like that.
Well, you have to do fishing. I guess unless you glitch it.
Yeah.
I don't think they glitch it. I'm pretty sure they do the fishing.
Yeah.
However, for them fishing, I remember the last time I watched a 100% boot speed run, the fishing, I think, was about a minute. Because there's a setup for getting the big fish.
Oh, cool. I missed Winking Carbank. Does it... Okay, it runs for 2 weeks. I can get it next week. The prices we pay to do these streams. I missed Winking Carbank. What will I do?
The hell is a Winking Carbank?
Fucking shuffle.
Oh, is it a Pokemon?
Yeah.
Carbank is the Pokemon. Winking is the, form?
I see.
It's specific to shuffle. In the main games, Winking, like, is not a specific thing. Mm. Shuffle just feels the need to have stupid content.
Okay, yeah, this is the longest cutscene in the game. Surprise! I like the detail on that thing she wears. I don't have no idea what it is, but...
But it's no longer necessary at this point.
Is it the sound of all the Sheik and Link pairings dying? I saw you as I was escaping from the castle.
Winking Zygarde win. Yeah, kind of surprised they haven't done that one yet.
What did I do?
Not sure why I'm doing the Latias stage when I should be doing Winking Slurp Swirlix. That's my top priority.
Yup, Zelda's the best. She's about to get captured. Zelda's the best! It's a shame as soon as they stick her in a dress, she's like becomes useless in all the games. Same thing in Wind Waker. I can't remember. I think Spirit Tracks was pretty good in Phantom Hourglass. I don't remember.
No, Phantom Hourglass, she is captured the entire
time. Oh, right. Okay. I think it's Spirit Tracks that does the
Isn't
the
she
Phantom
a ghost
thing,
on that
right?
one?
I don't think she's just as bad as Peach. Peach did not dress up and run around for 7 years trying to help the land. She becomes completely useless. Peach just goes, stands there and goes, Mario!
Mario, go fish!
Mama, I'm your mom! Paper Peach is pretty awesome. She's still captured, but she's still awesome. Because she's sassy.
Set it to
C's. Alright, well, in the time that that cutscene played out, I did one level of the Latias escalation and I beat Winking Swirlix.
Attention to the story?
Is there a story?
Oh, yeah, there's a story in this game. It's a good story. You foolish traitor. I commend you for avoiding my pursuit for 7 long years. Too bad you were an idiot at the very end and just kind of showed up at the Temple of Time, where I was probably the most likely to find you.
Okay, I'm gonna have to reset that stage.
And then stupid sexy saxophone music. Oh my god. Somebody needs to do that.
Ho 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 ho. It's literally just winking. Like, they have the regular Pokemon, and then they have another level of the same Pokemon, but it's in a, like, winking pose. And it has, like, usually a different ability. So yeah, it's pretty good, because there's still a good, like, 100 or so Pokemon that haven't had any kind of release, and yet they can make room for all this winking crap. And we got Ganon Crow.
I don't know, like, if, say you, I don't know, depends on if you're supposed to follow the ruler anyway, but secretly not like them, I don't know.
How did Ganon invade the Sacred Realm if he didn't have the Triforce of Courage?
He got in through the sword being pulled.
Oh.
It opened up a doorway.
Okay, that was the last one.
This fucking crow will never shut up.
Final one.
Nay, are you gonna go get the prize now?
Do I have to?
No.
It's not something...
No, you don't have to.
It's like, you just get it infinitely, so...
Yeah, I'm gonna see the pretty bridge.
I like how you go through all this effort just to make this piddly little bridge.
It is kind of sad looking. It looks better in the 3DS version.
It bridges a gap of like 20 feet.
We'll never not be reminded of Captain Planet. I'm
not doing
it.
Not doing what?
Getting the reward for 100.
In our hearts, we got the reward.
You just can't not show off what happens. Well, here's what happens. You talk to the guy. He's like, wow, you lifted the curse. Amazing, thanks. I have to reward someone like you. He gives you 200 rupees.
And that's it.
If you leave the room and come back, he gives you the 200 rupees again, and you can do this for infinite money.
There is
nothing to spend money on. Like, you can buy potions. You can buy fairies instead of finding them.
Our reward is getting the last golden scutula and getting the red... The red thing on the sculptural counter. This garbage trash.
So what was your favorite part of the run?
This part.
Because
we're nearing the end.
I couldn't say.
One cycling.
Anything that wasn't doing the freaking trading side quests.
I have a blank because I fell asleep towards some of it. So I'm not sure what happened. I remember nothing of the forest temple or the fire temple. I think I was asleep.
You fell asleep for, I think, most of the fire temple, yeah?
Yeah. No, I'm not going to be doing GTA.
Oh, I thought there was a platform there.
Nope. I think I got drunk in the middle of it.
A little bit, yeah.
And then I got better.
Got better. Yeah, it's like, I've never had a problem with doing the Ganon trials, but...
I always skip them, yeah. I've never... I don't think I've done the trials in many, many years.
Oh, you found the ROM hack? Awesome.
Yeah.
What's the name of it? If people are watching the upload of this, thread, they'll know what to search for.
That thread is fucking amazing to go through. It's even got Zeth in it.
It's got what?
Zeth. He's the one that's supposed to have done the revamp of the beta stuff, and we're making the big old ROM hack.
Oh, the Ura Zelda? The one that got, like, the super
drama. He stole everybody's money and then just kind of disappeared.
Sacred Angel? Okay.
That's what it was. See, I was thinking it was Fallen Angel or something, but I couldn't find it. I tried Googling Rudo's womb and it didn't work. No context. Yeah, it was pretty amazing. The textures he used are like, I love the Door of Time. Arrow in the head.
I love that.
We'll never not enjoy that. No, not No Man's Sky. It's Uru Zelda, Zeth64, basically lied about a bunch of progress they were doing on the ROM hack. And in fact, it was right around the time that Voyager was coming out. He was trying to convince me to actually not release it and continue to, like, work on it and, like, push back the date continuously. And I'm like, no, dude, I set a date. I'm releasing it here no matter what. And he got really angry and basically told everybody that the ROM hack was going to be shit and, like, got pissy because I was releasing a ROM hack that was technically finished and he didn't get to, so he had a really big pissy fit over it.
Why did he not want me to release? I don't understand.
Because he didn't want somebody else to have a released ROM hack before him. Essentially. Okay. It was really stupid. Yeah, he's kind of an asshole.
Yeah, it's never outright said in the game, but it's pretty heavily implied that the sages are all dead.
Sage is dead, yo.
I need to go into the shadow one, I think.
Third is planned to be inside the womb of Princess Rudo.
I might change her name, though. One of these
things is not like the others.
Oh, I didn't think about healing. I'll get a full heal when I talk to the Great Fairy. Can we shoot this fucker?
No, Fallen Angel, or whatever it's called, was never completed.
Really? Okay.
That was good. It just has the board posting on it.
Aiming.
Wasn't it all worth it?
Now what? The plot is amazing, Cheese. You cannot deny this plot.
Read it out loud.
It's a hole in the ocean floor, and the mine idea was mixed with concepts of Skyward Sword and the Game Boy games.
Are you going to throw me off the ledge? You are a piece of fucking shit.
You will enter Rudo's body directly, being you are an angel. Roxanne's father, now a demon, has raped Rudo, and you have to destroy the demon inside of her.
God.
Like, you got demon fetuses. Best game ever.
Not the first Nintendo game. No.
No, this hack thankfully was never
made. Come on with this shit!
Stun it.
But what is this?
It's easier to stun it first. Demon babies, 10 out of 10. It's so edge. Don't cut yourself.
Hopefully I can make it over that. I don't know if that was even how I was supposed to do that.
Yeah, I think if you had fallen, you'd have to restart the whole thing over too.
Isn't this where the gold gauntlets appear? How do I get them to spawn?
That's a master quest, isn't it? Don't you already have gold?
No.
Oh.
Probably just this. Yep.
Yeah, Temple of Time is totally a light temple. I like Link's pink boots and Sacred Angel. And the burning faces on the Door of Time. And just the overall...
What was the response? It was like, is it supposed to look like fucking garbage or something?
Yeah, it's like, is this supposed to look like shit? Like, there were no punches pulled in that thread. I loved it. Oh, she's found the doors! I love the doors!
And we have an arrow sticking for Impa.
It's supposed to be burning faces, Miles. Do you not see the, like, the absolute amazingness of them? Okay, what's the exact quote? It's amazing, whatever it is. What a horrible door texture. Please do something about it. It looks like garbage. Yeah, it's pretty great. I have them saved somewhere on the computer. And then the Great Fairy is even more amazing.
I love the Drunk Fairy.
How did you find the thread? I couldn't load up the, I couldn't load it up. It's like two baby red skulls talking into infinity. Are we just gonna ignore the Great Fairy? It's a mural of two people burning to death. Unless you can make a better one and are willing to donate to the project, the door will stay as it is. Triforce has been changed to blue, by the way.